Yo, what's up, you guys? Question. What do you do if there's something that you want, whether it be perfect health, love, or money, you name it, but then reason or your senses tell you that it's impossible? And if you're feeling that right now, then yo, this is gonna straight up encourage you. But before I get into it, hit that subscribe button and the bell right next to it to get your weekly dose of inspirational stories, tips, and teachings. Did you do it? Trust me, you don't wanna miss them. All right, let's do this. In her book, The Game of Life and How to Play It, Florence Gulbenshin talks about the time when this one guy came to her asking for treatments for success because he had to come up with $50,000 for his business by a certain time. And the time limit was almost up, which was why he went to her feeling all hopeless. And it sucked because no one wanted to invest in his enterprise. And even the bank flat out refused him a loan too. In other words, things weren't looking too good for him. So then Florence said to him that it's probably because he lost his temper at the bank and therefore his power, and that he can control any situation if he first controls himself. And she told him to go back to the bank and that she would treat. And her treatment was this. These are the words. You are identified in love with the spirit of everyone connected with the bank. Let the divine idea come out of this situation. When the guy heard that, he said, "Woman, you're talking about an impossibility. Tomorrow's Saturday. The bank closes at 12 and my train won't get me there until 10. And the time limit's up tomorrow. Anyway, they won't do it. It's too late." You gotta love Florence's confident response. She said, "God doesn't need any time and is never too late. With him, all things are possible." Let that sink in. And she's like, "I don't know anything about business, but I know all about God." And the guy was still doubtful and said, "You know, it all sounds fine when I sit here listening to you, but when I go out there, it's terrible." The conversation ended, and thing is, he lived kind of far away, so she didn't hear from him for about a week. But she ended up getting a letter from him saying that she was right. Why? Because he raised the money and said he'll never doubt the truth that she told him ever again. She saw him a few weeks later and asked what happened. Check this out. He said that his train was late and that he got there just 15 minutes to 12, 12 being the time it closes. And he walked right into the bank all quiet and said, "I've come for a loan." That's it. And then they gave it to him without question. Boom. It's awesome, right? Think about it. He made it 15 minutes before it closed. He could have missed it, but he didn't. He didn't miss it because infinite spirit is never too late. You see, in this guy's case, Florence said that he couldn't have done it alone. Okay, he needed someone to help him hold to the vision. And folks, this is what you can do for another person because that's what can happen, right? When you're in it, when you're in the situation yourself, it's sometimes hard to see because fear and doubt creeps in and starts distorting your vision. But then a friend or healer comes along who's on the outside, so to speak, can see things a lot clearer than you can because they're not too close to the situation. Is this making sense? That's why many times, not always, it can be easier to demonstrate for somebody else than for yourself. You know what I'm saying? Real talk now. If you're struggling at the moment, don't hesitate to ask for help. Seriously. Or if you're in a good place, you can be the one to lift someone up. There's a quote that goes like this. "No man can fail if some one person sees him successful. No man can fail if some one person sees him successful." That's the power of vision, you guys, which is why a lot of people admit in some way that they owe their success to their partner or to their sibling or friend who believed in them, who prayed and imagined for them, however you want to say it. Now, remember this, whatever it is that you want, it already exists. It already exists. That's why Florence says that you must hold the vision of your journey's end and demand the manifestation of that which you've already received. Because they're all finished and perfect ideas registered in divine mind, your own super conscious mind, which means they must come through you and not to you. And you'll get what you believe. Yeah. Alrighty guys, don't forget to hit that like button and to leave a review if you're listening via podcast. In case you didn't know, it gets more people to discover my work and of course help spread this message. And yo, don't forget to register for my free online training that'll seriously help you start manifesting the life you really want right now. So check it out. The link's in the description. Like I always say, more's coming. Till next time, I'm out. Peace.